Namaskar students, we are discussing about nutrition in animals. In my last video, I had discussed about human digestive system. Let us quickly recap the same before moving further. Okay. So we have learned that our digestive system comprises with the human alimentary canal and associate glands. We have also read about the different parts of the alimentary canal, starting from the mouth or buccal cavity. Then is the esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. Here in the diagram, we'll see it again. We have also read about the different steps involved in the process of nutrition. It starts from the ingestion, that means taking in the food inside the mouth. So we, by the process of ingestion, we put our food inside our mouth. From mouth, it passes to the esophagus or food pipe. Then to the stomach, from stomach to small intestine, and then to the large intestine, and then rectum, and then through the anus, the process of ingestion occurs. One thing we need to keep in the mind, you know, though this intestine is called the small one, but it is not actually small. Its length is about 7.5 meter approximately, you know, but this large intestine, it's 1.5 meter only. So why it is called the small intestine? Because the diameter of this coiled tube like structure is lesser than the large intestine. Okay, this is fitted in our abdominal cavity. Clear? Now let us start with the function of different parts of the alimentary canal, starting with the mouth and buccal cavity. Clear? Now we all know that mouth contains the tongue, teeth and salivary gland. It is interesting to know the digestion begins in the mouth itself. Okay, so food is taken into the body through the mouth. The process of taking food into the mouth is called, we have already read, yes, it is called ingestion. Okay, we chew the food with the teeth and break it down mechanically into small pieces. Okay, each tooth is rooted in a separate socket in the gums. We will see the diagram to understand this later. Okay, our teeth vary in appearances and perform different functions. That's why they are given different names. We can see over here, this is the arrangement of teeth in different type of teeth also has been shown over here. Here the front one, you can see, this is called incisor. Then is the this two called canine. Then is the premolars, you can see, and then is the molars. Okay, before moving forward, let us see some information regarding our teeth. As we know that at birth, a human infant has no teeth. The first teeth appear after 6 months or so, okay, and fall off between 6 to 8 years of age. These are called milk teeth and they are temporary. There are 20 milk teeth. Okay, now milk teeth are replaced by permanent teeth at around the age of 6. Permanent teeth are 32 in number. Let us know about the different types of teeth now. As we know, teeth are located in our jaws, in lower and upper jaws, in the mouth cavity. They are fixed to the gums. Now, based on this structure and function, teeth are of 4 types. This is the incisor, canine, premolar and molar. Here, I have written all the where it is present, number of those teeth and the function of each one. So the incisor in the front, how many? 4 plus 4 means in each jaw, number 4, 4 in number, the incisors are present. Altogether it is 8. And what it is, main function? Biting of food. Okay. Then is a canine that is present either side of incisors. They are also 2 plus 2, total in 4 in number. And its main function is to piercing and tearing. Then is the premolar behind the canine. It is total number It's 4 plus 4, 8. And its main function is chewing and grinding food. The last one is the molar at the back of this, at the last it is present. And then its total number 6 plus C, that means altogether 12. And its main function is chewing and grinding the food. Clear? There are 16 teeth in each jaw, with a total of 32 teeth in the mouth cavity, as I said. Okay. However, in young people, there are a total of 8 molars in all. The second set of 4 molars develops at the age of 18 or more. These are called wisdom teeth. Okay. Now, here you can see the structure of a tooth. This is the crown part. This is the root part. This crown part, the white portion is called the enamel, and we can see this part, and all these parts are in fitted in the inside the gum. Okay, clear? To understand the function of those kind of teeth, you can do this activity by yourself. Okay, and then you can write, as just we have discussed about all those numbers and function is already given over here, you can put over here. Clear? Let us first discuss about the tongue, then we will see the functioning of this buccal cavity, or which part of the digestion takes part in the buccal cavity. Okay, so the tongue of a fleshy muscular organ is attached at the back and free at the front. It can be moved in all directions. Now the functions are written over here. I will ask you to write down the functions point wise. Okay, as I am telling, you just follow that. Okay, so what are its functions? The first function you can write, helps in mixing and chewed food with saliva. Then you can write that it helps in swallowing food. Then helps to detect different taste of food with the help of taste buds. Yes, you understand? And you know that taste buds present on the tongue can be detect 4 basic tests: salty, sour, sweet and bitter. This taste can be identified in different areas of the surface of tongue. Let us see the structure and the areas where those taste buds are present. Here you can see, you need to draw this diagram with this by labeling these parts. You can see the bitter, that we can taste over here. Through this part we can taste sour and then salty and sweet. Clear? Okay, let us discuss about the digestion in mouth. As I said, the digestion starts from the mouth. Now we have read that our mouth has the salivary glands which secretes saliva. Now what is this saliva? The saliva is a watery substance secreted by salivary glands in the mouth. You know, it contains 99% of water. Okay, and also contains the digestive enzyme that we call it saliva. Okay, so the tongue, as I said, the tongue helps in the mixing of the saliva with the food. So when we are putting the food in our buccal cavity, our teeth is there for chewing and mastication. Mastication means changing the food, the solid food, into small pieces, and then the saliva is secreted by the salivary glands, and with the help of tongue it means mixes with the food and then make it soft. Another function saliva performs, what is that? Now the juice, as I said, this saliva present in saliva helps in chemical digestion of starch into sugar. Once again I am repeating, the juice present in saliva help in chemical digestion of starch into sugar. Okay, now what happens after the food is broken down into smaller pieces and mixed with saliva? It is swallowed down the digestive system and enters to the food pipe, or also it is called esophagus. I hope it is clear. Once again, let me repeat it. We are putting the food inside our mouth, then our teeth is changing into smaller pieces by chewing it, and then this salivary gland is pouring their juice, that is called the saliva. Saliva is helping in the partial digestion, mind it, complete digestion of starch is not occurring here. Partial digestion of the starch is occurring over here. Now that food that is become now soft and change into smaller pieces will enter to the next part of the alimentary canal, that is the food pipe or esophagus. But let us perform one activity over here to find out that effect of saliva on starch. As I said, in science you need to prove everything. So what we have to do, we need to take two test tubes and we need to label them A and B. Okay, now in test tube A, put one teaspoonful of boiled rice, and in test tube B, keep one teaspoonful of boiled rice after chewing it for 3 to 5 minutes. Why we are chewing it? That we are letting the saliva mixing with the boiled rice. Okay, see afterward what happened. Here I have written point wise. As I said, always the activities we need to write in step wise. So I'm not again discussing about this aim and the material required. Let us move to the observation. Okay, now come from here, the third step of the procedure. Now what we have to do, we have to add 4 to 5 milliliter of water and 2 to 3 drops of iodine solution in each test tube. Okay, now after that, what we will observe, the test tube A gives a blue black color, but in the second one no change in color is observed. Why it is so? The boiled rice in the test tube A contains starch. That is why it gives blue-black color on being tested with iodine. But in the chewed rice, in the test tube B, starch has been broken down or digested into sugar. Therefore, no blue-black color develops with iodine. Hope it is clear to you. In my next video, I will discuss about the dental caries and about the all other parts of the alimentary canal with its function. Namah Shivaya.